the name Cuatro Ciénegas, Cuatro is four in Spanish, and Ciénegas is marshes.
These high mountainous areas basically collect the rain in this arid desert area and funnel it down into the valley floor. We have this really unique series of springs in the middle of the desert.
Starting about 1960 or so, biologists discovered this place. They started finding lots of new species which weren't known anywhere else. There's lots of water in the middle of the desert, which makes it very special. And over the years, the 60s and 70s, there were lots of explorations that found an incredibly high number of endemic species, or species that just occur here, both plants and animals. And it's basically due to the long persistence of wetlands in what is now a desert. It's like the Galapagos in that it has many endemic species that are known only from, in that case, the Galapagos Islands. Here they're known from the wetlands of Cuatro Ciénegas in the Sea of the Chihuahuan Desert. In Mexico, almost in all cases, protected areas have been declared on top of private lands or ejido lands.
And since most of the work is on privately owned land, most of our job entails giving incentives to landowners such that conservation does not become a burden to them. But it's always a challenge.
No había necesidad para nosotros, como dueños particulares de ese rancho. Desde hace 40 años que los tenemos, desde hace 40 años que lo manejamos conservándolo.
There's an endemic box turtle. All of the box turtles, with the exception of this one, are terrestrial. This one is clearly aquatic. It spends almost all of its life in water. Algae grows on its shell. And that's what brought biologists here. They came looking for this strange turtle. They found it, and then all this other species that occur here as well.
Their habitat has just contracted incredibly. There are records of these things from all along the edges of the mountain, lots of areas where there's now no water at all.
He nacido aquí en este lugar y somos de una familia que tiene alrededor de cuatro generaciones. Aquí era un oasis, el pueblo, porque brotaba mucha agua y salía y regaba todo. Había muchas huertas de nogales, de duraznos y por todos lados veías granados y todo eso. Entonces empiezan las explotaciones del cañón hacia allá, agrícolas con pozos fuertes, y empieza a bajar el nivel.
The agriculture that's gone on here for the past 20 years is using groundwater. The results of the withdrawal of groundwater has dried the springs that used to feed the Rio Cañon, that provided the water to run the wheat mill and also irrigate the orchards of Cuatro Ciénegas, which are all now essentially dry.
Ha sufrido un cambio que en realidad los años, o sea, es muy corto el lapso de pérdida de agua, o sea, de líquido vital.
Mucha gente ha peleado por lo que es el rancho que está aquí al salir del cañón. Esos son los que están sustrayendo mucho agua. Y por eso esta cosa se acabó.
Llegan, explotan y se van.
First came down in January of 1979.
This area was one big marshland with a lake right here and a stream that flowed back to the springs that fed it from the marsh. But this was always at least partly full of water. The marsh plants have died off and these invading species have taken over.
Ahorita el agua aquí en Cuatro Ciénegas es un gran tema. La falta de agua proveniente del cañón de una u otra forma ha impactado también aquí al municipio de Cuatro Ciénegas, porque el agua es vida y el agua representa fuentes de empleo también.
Estoy dedicado a lo que se ha dedicado mi familia por... Yo soy la cuarta generación a producir vinos de la calidad que nosotros sabemos hacerla, con las recetas y tradiciones del bisabuelo todavía. esto había agua y había mucha fruta. Ahorita no hay agua, no hay nada.
Mi familia tiene en Cuatro Ciénegas, yo creo que fácil unos 150 años. Desde luego que la identidad de nuestro pueblo con toda la República Mexicana, como lo más cerca, ¿verdad? Pues nuestro pueblo es una de las 13 maravillas de nuestra República Mexicana. Y realmente, ¿cómo nos puede afectar que una de esas 13 maravillas llegue a desaparecer?
We learn how to swim at the sequía. There was enough water to play and to swim. Everything was so green, so beautiful. That would be very sad if our granddaughters and grandchildren wouldn't be able to enjoy this.
Ahorita está habiendo crisis porque no se ha manejado con un criterio de sustentabilidad. Yo siempre he pensado que siempre pueden coexistir la sustentabilidad con la productividad agrícola, ganadera, etcétera, etcétera.
So we have basically this treasure of biodiversity here, and it's, you know, could disappear in the near future. So that makes me feel like, in addition to it being an ideal place to study, it's also really necessary that we study it now.
I'm convinced there are some things we could do locally to manage the water in different ways to help bring back water levels. And somehow we're going to have to get all these people talking to each other and come to some understanding that will really allow Cuatro Ciénegas to persist as a natural area and allow humans to continue to exist here in sort of peace with the natural system. Families have lived here for many, many generations. Everybody is proud of the place and everybody wants to see it as beautiful as it once used to be.
We believe that a lot of the potential for Cuatro Ciénegas is nature-based tourism. The tourism that currently exists, which is mostly people wanting to take a dip in a pool or in a poza, is going to be becoming more sophisticated.
El futuro de Cuatro Ciénegas está ligado al turismo, al ecoturismo, por la particularidad tan importante que tiene Cuatro Ciénegas. O sea, la gente tiene que tener la manera de vivir, por eso andamos tras esa sustentabilidad. Tenemos que invitar también a empresarios que estén comprometidos con la gente y comprometidos con el medio ambiente. Cuando eso suceda, Cuatro Ciénegas puede ser un modelo de desarrollo económico basado en la sustentabilidad.